On to our first feature then, and this week it comes from Magdeburg in Germany, the European Hot Air Ballooning Championships, with our reporter Tim Russo.
Magdeburg, on the banks of the mighty River Elbe, is one of Germany's most historic cities, dating back more than 1,000 years when it was established as the capital of Otto the Great's famous empire. Today it hosts the 15th FAI European Hot Air Ballooning Championships, with more than 80 pilots from 24 countries challenging for the most prestigious title in Europe, and it promises to be the best yet.
But you can see a lot because the weather forecast is perfect, so we will have very good flyable conditions. We have 83 teams from 24 nations, and if we take off twice a day, this makes a lot of flights. There's certainly Uwe Schneider from Germany, he is the current champion. David Barefoot from the UK, he has been European Championship a couple of times, as well as world champion. There are some Spanish guys who are very good, some Hungarian guys, some Lithuanian guys. They are really the best pilots in Europe. They have proven it before in national championships and now fighting for the title.
These are Europe's best balloon pilots, many of them national champions in their own right. Magdeburg is in the heart of prime ballooning territory, with flat land, extensive fields in which to take off and land, and generally benign weather conditions. Tasks are being set by Claude Weber and Dominique Hegeny.
Well, we need to find out a proper task for tonight that everybody likes to fly, and the wind is good for that. I mean, we can't set a task or a target somewhere where the wind doesn't blow to. It's also our experience how we judge the weather informations we get and how to judge what is flyable with a balloon. We can't set anything you need to fly at 10,000 feet all the time. Because we are also balloon pilots, we know about what the pilots expect, what kind of skills, and what also is possible to do that.
Mike Howard is one of Great Britain's leading balloon pilots and was soon in the air for the championship's first flight. Mike is a 41-year-old commercial airline pilot from Bristol with a wealth of competitive experience.
I've learned over time that I fly better solo. I have the computer on board and it shows me my position, it shows me my track to where I'm going. You're talking to your crew, they're giving you information on the ground as to balloons, what's happened to balloons on the ground, are they going left or right, how to approach a task. When we're talking a meter can be the difference between first place and 50th place. You've really got to be in on these targets. So yes, there's only me in the basket, but it's not a one-man team, it's very much a team effort.
Mike has been British champion three times and started this event with a maximum score.
I had two goals this week, being the top Brit and finishing in the top 10. If you can get yourself in the top 10, you can then win. If you're not in the top 10, you can't win. The top 10 are the people who contend in the first place.
Belgium's Yann Timmers leads the way after the first evening of competition, closely followed by Frenchman François Messine. Mike Howard was in sixth place. By day three, Dutchman Henk Broders, joint leader after the very first task, could drop down the field.
I'm going to put the covers over the poles, so it looks nicer. And then the liquid hoses are safe. Connect the liquid hose on this cylinder, so during inflation flight I can have some propane out of my burners. A little radio, so I can hear other pilots talking to each other or to me. And this is my altimeter and variometer. I can see how high I will be and how fast I will be sent.
If you want to search for the best pilot, the pilot should always fly alone. He only should have a compass, an altimeter, a map, a pencil, and that's it. And then you find the best pilot. A balloon you should fly with the burner, with the propane, and it just go to a goal. Just, that's it. That's the way of flying balloons.
you on the wind reading is the direction to, and here is the wind from. This is the difference. I hope you it is clear.
This is roughly the heights with the directions and the speed of the winds. So at the moment we have constantly southeasterly winds, and the higher you go, the more southerly it's going to be, with more speed.
The flight time of the Hare is about 40 minutes plus or minus 15 approximate.
That's a Hare that goes up as a first balloon. Yeah. And approximately 5 or 10 minutes later, all the pilots are allowed to go and follow it. He will fly for approximately 40 minutes, then he'll land, put out a cross in the field, and we are supposed to drop this yellow marker as close as possible to the center of this cross.
Henk has been Dutch champion 10 times since starting competitive ballooning 20 years ago. He's flown more than 4,000 hours, one of the most experienced competition pilots in the world. His best finish in the Europeans was 6th in 2005.
It was in the early 70s as a child and as a pilot since 1986. And in the meantime, I flew about 4,500 times.
Every balloon pilot relies on his ground crew for a constant stream of information about wind speeds and directions. It's like a Formula One racing team. This evening's tasks were a hare and hounds where all competitors chase one balloon. And a judge declared goal.
I love ballooning. Yes, I'm addicted to it.
It's like heroin,
but then cheaper.
Unfortunately, this was another disappointing flight for Henk.
The flight was average. At the first task, I came down just 1 minute too late. So I just passed the target, and I hoped with the ground wind to go back to the cross, but not enough. And the second one was a little bit too close behind the first target, so you couldn't really maneuver to it. You just stay where you were. I tried to maneuver a little bit, went faster than another balloon, came down, hit my envelope to his envelope, I pushed him to the cross, and it pushed me away from the cross.
The modern technology disliked so much by the traditionalists means the scorers can plot the path of every pilot via GPS loggers.
This is what's generated by the GPS loggers they have on board, and the discussion we're having is at what point it entered into the scoring area, just because it does make several metres difference here, there and whatever. So that's what we're looking at, and this is the brown area is actually a defined scoring area that they had to fly through, and they had to fly as long as possible within that scoring area.
After 14 tasks, Germany's Uwe Schneider, winner of the past two European Championships, leads the field, on course for a unique hat-trick. Frenchman Francois Messine, runner-up in 2000, is close behind. Making the most of the best weather means that the balloon pilots are always on the road before dawn. This is day 4, and the competitors are searching for the best takeoff location. Gregor Vičius is one of 4 Lithuanians among the leading pack, evidence of the increasing challenge from Eastern Europe. This morning's four tasks include a hesitation waltz and maximum distance. Challenges that were to prove extremely tricky for even the top pilots. For the inhabitants of the beautiful Elbe villages close to Magdeburg, there was a colourful sight waiting for them as they got up for work. The challenge of the morning's tasks involves staying in the air for at least 20 minutes after the last target. Something that proved beyond the skills of a few. A mixed morning for our Lithuanians as Tadas landed with a score that dropped him well out of the leading places. Even reigning champion Uwe Schneider and the vastly experienced Dutchman Matthias de Bruin had found the morning's tasks challenging.
The problem was that we had to fly after the last goal for 20 minutes. There's woods here, there's 3 kilometers of woods, and I have no gas anymore, all the gas is gone. So I didn't know, is it enough, is it not enough, and I wanted to ask them if they know. But they didn't know, and that's why I shouted them. At first they didn't understand me, but it's fine. I mean, that's the excitement anyhow. I'm a person that is excited. That's okay. It looks like a gentle sport, but the action is quite enormous. The approaches to the goals, where everybody is bouncing each other and for the best position, that's where the problems start. And then one bounces you away, and the other one, and then you have to take care not to bounce another one. And well, a lot of action.
The 15th European Championships are developing into a two-horse race between reigning champion Schneider and Messina France, but there's no doubting the strength of the Eastern European Challenge.